Hey, what up guys, my name is Cyril Zuma. Welcome back to my channel where I talk all things photography. On this episode, I'll be sharing with you guys 5 tips on how to shoot better portraits. Tip number 1, shoot raw. Now, the reason why you want to shoot raw versus shooting JPEG is when you shoot raw, you have more power so that when you get into something like Photoshop or Lightroom, you have much more power in editing your photos. So you are able to manipulate the colors, you are able to manipulate a whole lot more things other than when you're actually shooting with JPEG. JPEG is almost a compressed image that doesn't have enough information. So tip number 1 is shoot raw. Tip number 2, direct your subject. Now, this is one of the most important tips that you should take from this. I mean, look, they're all important, but this is one of the most important. You need to be able to direct your subject so that you can get the results that you want to get out of the shoot. So you've done mood boards, you've done everything, you've planned for it, and now you are at the shoot. And I've seen quite a lot of photographers where they neglect now taking control of everything else, thinking everything has been done post-production or pre-production rather. But what you need to do is be able to direct your subject during the shoot. So if it means that you need to tell them to turn their head, then let them know that they need to turn their head. Communicate with them as much as you can. Use your hands, smile more. And it'll basically give them the impression that you know exactly what's going on, and you should know what's going on actually. And it would also give them the confidence that you are in control of what's going on and you know everything that's about to happen. So tip number 2, direct your subject. Tip number 3, focus. Now, focus is super important. You know, you can miss the whole message of a photo because the focus is wrong. So my third tip is focus on the closest eye to the camera. If you're shooting your subject from this angle and they're facing this direction here, then focus on the closest eye to the camera. Do not focus on this eye here. What focusing on the closest eye does, you know, it draws your viewer to that eye, number one, and it also just lets everybody else know that you know exactly what you're doing. And nobody wants to focus on something that's back here. I think it doesn't make sense, because what will happen is the rest of the skin here will be blurred out and it just won't look nice at all. So focus on the closest eye to the camera, and this should definitely help you in taking better portraits. Tip number 4, shoot at a small aperture. Now, I know how exciting it is when you get a lens that's 1.4, 1.2 or 1.8 to be shooting at 1.8 or 1.2. But when you actually don't understand your lens and your camera that well, you may lose focus on your subject and it turns out to be a bad photo. So make sure that you're shooting at a small aperture. And by small aperture, I mean you're shooting at something from 2.8, f2.8 up. And that way, you will be able to get most of your subject in focus. If you want a blurred background, the best thing you can do is move your subject further away from the subject so that it is blurred out. And you carry on using f2.8 going up and your background will be blurred. That's how you can actually get blur or bokeh, as some people call it, the best way. So that's tip number 4. Last but not least, back button focus. It'll make your photos stand out. It'll make your job so much easier. So tip number 5 is back button focus. Use it as much as you can. Basically, back button focus is a button normally on my camera. I know that it's on the right hand side of my camera. I press that button, I focus on my subject, and that allows me to be able to then recompose my subject a little bit better. Now, some cameras have focusing points in different places. I know the camera I'm using right now to shoot, the 6D, which is my main camera, the focusing points, they aren't that many. So sometimes I need to be able to focus on the subject, then find my composition and then take the photo. So back button focus helps you there. And you will notice some newer or older cameras rather don't have that many focus points. And this is where back button will come up. So do yourself a favor, Google about back button focus, watch some videos on how back button focus works. But back button focus is one of the most important tips you want to learn in photography to make your job a bit easier. Thank you for watching. That was 5 tips on how to take better portraits as a beginner photographer. Now, if you liked this video, please go ahead and press the thumbs up and also leave a comment for me. If you have not subscribed, please subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you receive more videos just like this from me. Till next time, goodbye.